I'm Assistant Sheriff Todd Fasulo. I'm here today to give you an update on our officer-involved shooting that occurred on Saturday, December 9th, 2017. Before I get into the facts of the case, I'd like to talk about our holiday initiative because I think it's important to this story. As many of you are aware, because we did a media rollout on it, we kicked off what we call our holiday initiative the week before Thanksgiving. The holiday initiative is an annual deployment of resources and officers to combat violent crime and robberies in high populated shopping areas and hot spots around the city. Our goal during this time is to have officers in the area of shopping centers and malls to hopefully prevent robberies, and if they occur, to apprehend the suspects quickly. On Saturday, when the call came out about a suspect who had attempted two robberies in close proximity that was broadcast on our patrol radio, an officer soon spotted that suspect vehicle. I'll now provide the details of this specific incident. For this year, this is officer-involved shooting number 22. It's non-fatal number 12. And at the same time last year, we had 8 officer-involved shootings and 5 non-fatal. The date and time of this call was on December 9th, 2017 at 10:20 a.m. and the location was 1591 North Decatur, and it was an attempted robbery call, and you'll see the location on the map on the screen to my left. The location of the actual officer-involved shooting, the scene was a terrible Herx gas station at the intersection of North Decatur and Vegas Drive. You can see the location also on the map to my left. The time of the actual officer-involved shooting, shots were fired at approximately 10:50 a.m. The involved officer is Sergeant Miguel Garcia. He is 39 years old and has been with the LVMPD for 16 years. He is assigned to our Community Policing Division at Bolden Area Command. In this incident, Sergeant Garcia was armed with a Kimber 1911 45 caliber handgun equipped with a tactical light. The investigation revealed Sergeant Garcia fired 4 rounds from his handgun during this incident, and he was wearing his body-worn camera during it, and it was not activated. However, there were multiple officers on scene with activated body-worn cameras. I will show you the videos at the conclusion of my remarks. Our arrestee, who is shown to my left, is Richard Mitchell. He's 54 years old. He's a black male adult, 5'9", 195 pounds. He has a very extensive criminal history out of California and has one arrest here in Nevada. Some of his priors out of California is he's been arrested for robbery 3 times and convicted. He's been arrested for assault with a deadly weapon. He's been arrested 4 times for drug-related offenses. He's been arrested 2 times for battery domestic violence, 2 times for a normal battery. And then also he's been arrested 4 times for parole violations and battery on a police officer. In Nevada, he has been arrested for open container and ex-felon failure to register from North Las Vegas. Mitchell is currently being held at the Clark County Detention Center. He's being held on 2 counts of attempted robbery, malicious destruction of private property, and resisting a police officer with a deadly weapon. I'll show you on my left a picture of that deadly weapon. He was carrying a baseball bat. And here are the details of the actual officer-involved shooting. On Saturday, December 9th of 2017 at 10:20 a.m., patrol officers were dispatched to a CVS pharmacy located at 6300 West Lake Mead Boulevard to investigate an attempted robbery. The suspect and vehicle description matched the details of another attempted robbery that had occurred at a Speedy Mart located on North Rainbow Boulevard in Alexander about 30 minutes prior. It was reported in one of the previous robberies that the suspect stated he had a gun. Patrol units were ordered to saturate the area and look for the suspect vehicle associated with both of these attempted robberies. At approximately 10:47 a.m. or 27 minutes after the second robbery attempt, the suspect vehicle was located by officers, parked in front of a terrible Herx gas station located at 1591 North Decatur. The suspect was parked on the north side of the building in a handicapped parking spot, facing in towards the building. As officers approached to make contact with the vehicle, Mitchell exited the driver's side of the car armed with a baseball bat in his hand. Officers issued numerous verbal commands in an effort to gain compliance for several minutes from Mitchell and have him put the bat down on the ground. Mitchell became more and more agitated as officers ordered him to drop the bat and officers deployed a less lethal shotgun. As more officers arrived, Mitchell became more agitated and continued to disregard the officer's verbal commands. At the same time, he walked up from the actual parking lot and onto the sidewalk adjacent to the entry of the Terrible Herbst. At that time, one officer fired four rounds from the low-lethal shotgun, striking Mitchell, which was ineffective. Mitchell became enraged and began striking the glass doors on the north side of the business with a baseball bat, shattering the glass door. Mitchell then opened the doors and began to enter into the business with the baseball bat. To prevent Mitchell from entering the store and to prevent patrons and the clerk from being injured, Sergeant Garcia fired four rounds from his pistol. Mitchell was struck one time on his right thigh, and he continued to enter into the Terrible Herbst. Officers then ran in after him and placed him into custody without further incident. He was transported to UMC with a non-life-threatening injury, and I will now show you some body cam video obtained from the officers during the incident.
Hey, we don't want to hurt you, man. Relax, come on. We're not here to hurt you, man. We gotta drop it down, man. Transfer to a taser. Taser. Listen, man, you're, hey, calm down, man. Relax. Listen, man, we gotta figure out this call, okay? But you gotta calm down. Drop the bat, man. Drop the bat. Okay, well, drop the bat first, okay? Listen, man. We're giving commands right now. Drop the... Give him better commands, but he's not. He's refused to drop the baseball bat. Listen, man, just drop the bat, okay? We gotta investigate your car, man.
Huh?
We gotta investigate your car.
What car?
Your car, man, and you.
What car?
Listen, man, you've been seen going around to different places, okay? Asking for money. That's the case that you want? Hey, listen, man. Listen, we gotta figure this out, but you gotta drop the bat.
Put the bat down, sir.
You gotta drop the bat, man.
I got the vehicle.
You got the vehicle?
Alright.
Keep your hands up!
Hey man, come on. We don't want to hurt you, man. We don't want to hurt you.
What
we gonna do? 276. Can you call the Turbo gas station to make sure they lock the door? Okay, well, just drop it, man. Listen, I'm gonna. Listen, hey.
Put the baseball bat down, sir.
What is? What do you want with me?
Listen.
Just talk to you. That's it.
About what?
Listen.
Listen to him, man.
About what? That's it.
What?
If you haven't done anything wrong, you don't have to worry about it.
I'm just saying. What do you want?
What's that?
I don't know what y'all ran up on me for.
You put it down! Put it down! Beanbag! Beanbag! Beanbag!
Drop it! Drop it! Drop it! Drop it! Drop it, man! Drop it! Drop the base! Drop it! Drop it! Drop it! Keep
it! Hey!
Hey!
Hey, am I?
Shots fired.
Drop the baseball bat.
Fucking damn it.
Put him out. On his stomach.
Move him.
I got his head.
Okay.
I got right hand.
I got cuffs.
Okay.
Pat him down.
What the fuck you want with me?
Get out of there, go out of the store.
Beanbag.
Hey, Ron,
another one.
Hey, drop it!
Drop the bat.
Fucking Sammy. No.
Put him out. On his stomach.
Flip him.
Move him.
I got his head.
Okay, segment.
I got right here.
Segment.